Man. Hey, I got to keep something 1,000,000,000% motherfucking real about this interview, man. This is probably one of the greatest interviews in the history of internet interviews and even interviews you may be able to witness on television. But what this topic that this dude touched on, this is a divorced attorney out of New York, James Saxton, who speaks on in this interview about relationships. It's based on the history of his career, what he sees in marriages, and just going off experiences and observation. That's what life is about, experience and observation through clear and free free mind and unconspiratory thoughts, not flipping into some dimension of shit that ain't fucking real about how you assessed and how you view things. In my opinion, what I've always stated in this interview and what I hear is a lot of shit I say. And this dude, even with the cussing, people hear me talk, I cuss and all that other shit, but my brain functions. This interview is just, man, out of the park, man, on point with a lot of this shit about what, how people go into relationships and what leads to the faltering of a lot of these marriages that dissolve into divorce and these, you know, very volatile disputes on how you go about splitting things and the breakdown of stuff in marriages and what people look into, the certain people, you know, certain marriages that they go into, relationships, and whether they're built on true love. Some people go in it for the financial reasoning. Some people go in to try to find them a trophy. And then all these other, you know, superficial values. And then people find themselves making these horrific mistakes. But this interview was on point. That's why it ended up being a two-hour interview. And every second of it is worth listening to that shit. But also listening to that shit is also kind of, you know, sifting through this shit and extrapolating a lot of shit that works for, you know, to finding healthy and perfect relationships, that you ain't going there and putting all pressures of thinking the guy's supposed to only do this or the woman is, her role is to only do this. People have to learn to find, you know, how to be humans that truly love each other, that the value of a dollar ain't the thing that is the principle of a fucking relationship. Yeah, people, you have to survive in this motherfucking world, but money shouldn't be the only factor. You find people that you gel well with. Because at the end of the day, you find that money doesn't always make people happy. And like you said, a lot of his clients are very wealthy people. And you find them making the same mistakes. Certain type of people they look for. And they'll repeat the same cycles, which is insane. And end up with the same fucking results. Like, this was a great ass fucking interview that just dropped. I don't even think this video has been up for even an hour. I mean, for like 3 hours. I don't even think it's been up for 3 hours yet. Just newly released drop that he put out. And Soft White Underbelly, I put a lot of his videos on my Instagram. I load them up on there or share in the community on my YouTube page. And he's always got great shit. The type of people he interviews, you just don't find people doing this shit. The other great orator and fucking being able to interview people would be like Joe Rogan. But this guy is really knocking out the park with the type of guests he brings on. But and then I got clues Shannon Sharp on that shit as well. But that's all I got on this one, man. Y'all check that Soft White Underbelly shit out, man. It's a great ass interview. And if you with your lady, watch it with her. Ladies, watch this shit. Listen to this. A lot of people will listen to this shit, and the first thing they have when they hear certain things about relationships, they have these, you know, reactionary responses, which the response is always negative and being one that's combative and opposed to a lot of shit. And that's the, a lot of the chicks who have those type reactions are the problems with a lot of shit. And it'd be beautiful fucking chicks. A lot of y'all be single and shit because it's difficult as fuck to work with and shit. But that's all I got. Catch you on the next one, man. Always right with Reggie Owens in this motherfucking. A lot of shit from people hear me talk when we talk relationship type shit. Or people hear me in person where I always express I'm not a marriage type person. And it's not one thing of running from marriage, but the type of bullshit people put up with, Reg is just not that dude. I won't put up with a lot of shit that, you know, comes with a lot of the common relationships that, well, we find ourselves involved with. I enjoy the experiences, and when shit goes bad, man, we got to end this experience. Like, I enjoy the good moments in it, but anybody put up with too much of the bad shit, and then I go off to hating you. Like, I ain't with none of that type of shit. You know, I got the writing is on the wall, and man, this is a great one. But that's all I got. Peace.